everybody, welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at the June 3rd lead coding challenge. And the question is to city scheduling. Now, this classifies under the easy questions of greedy algorithm. And in this video, we're going to go through a short explanation of the algorithm, then take a look at the algorithm coded in Python. And yeah, so that's about it. If you already kind of know the algorithm and just want to skip to the code, please feel free to do that. Otherwise, let's start this together. Now, two-city scheduling is basically a question that asks you to find the most optimized cost of bringing participants to two cities, right? So now in this, let me just explain this with the example input that's given. Now you're gonna have a list as an input, right? And each element in this list is in itself a list, right? And each list will have two elements. Now two elements represent the cost of bringing the first person into city one and city two. So if you look closely here, you can see that the cost of bringing the first person to city A is 10 and the cost of bringing the first person to city B is 20, right? So that way you have four people here, right? And the cost of bringing them each to city 1 and city 2 is mentioned. Now your job here is to output the optimized cost given the constraint that we want equal number of people to go to each city. Right, so if I have four people, I want two people to go to city one and two people to go to city two. So both cities should have equal people. So so let's start off with a little diagram that I've created to help you understand the algorithm that we're going to follow here. So let's pick up this example input itself, right? So if you okay, so here is a graph that I've created. Now, let's assume that the four people are called Tom, Jerry, Ed, and Dexter. And let's say we have two cities, Moscow and Tokyo. So according to the input given, say if dark blue represents Moscow and light blue represents Tokyo, I have plotted the costs of getting each of them to the city. So if you see, this is the same as the question. We have 10, 20, 30, 200, 450, 30, 20. So the cost of getting Tom to Moscow is 10 and the cost of getting Tom to Tokyo is 20 and so on. Now, let's say, just vaguely to start approaching this problem, let's say everybody flies to Moscow. Okay, so let's just put that, just put things in perspective. Let's say everybody flies to Moscow. Now, if everybody flies to Moscow, the cost of getting each person to Moscow has to be added in order to calculate the total cost. So, Tom traveling to Moscow costs 10, Jerry traveling to Moscow costs 30, Ed 400, and Dexter 30. Now, if you add all of this up, you get 470. But, according to the constraint in the question, we want two people in Moscow and two people in Tokyo. So now the question arises, which two cities here must we switch with Tokyo in order to have the equal balance in the cities? So I've created a small chart here. Now, in every solution that you see here, two cities are Moscow and two cities are Tokyo. So let's pick up a sample one. Okay, so let's say the third one where Tom goes to Tokyo, Jerry goes to Moscow, Ed goes to Tokyo, and Dexter goes to Moscow. So adding this up, we get a total of 130. Now, our program should be able to pick the least out of all of the costs. And according to this chart, the least is the first entry, where Tom and Jerry go to Moscow, Ed and Dexter go to Tokyo. So the question now is that how do we know from our first assumption that Ed and Dexter have to be actually sent to Tokyo and not Moscow? Now, take a closer look at our initial costs that are given in the question. see what's the similarity between the two that we switched. So if you take a look at it closely, you will see that the differences in the values between the cost of getting that person to Moscow versus the cost of getting that person to Tokyo is actually the least, right? So if you calculate here, we get a difference of 10. So here you get a difference of 10. Then here you get 170. Here you have minus 350. And here you have minus 10. So these two entries, that is Ed and Dexter, have the least difference between the cost of getting them to Moscow versus the cost of getting them to Tokyo. Hence, we know that these are the ones we need to switch to Tokyo. Now, when we talk about it in the algorithm, when we code, these are the four steps essentially that we need to follow. The first step would be to fly everybody to one city. So say city A. Then we evaluate the differences. Just like we did in the previous place, we evaluated the differences between getting the person from B and A and so on. So you evaluate the differences and then you choose the two smallest differences, right? So just like we did, So just like we did here, we picked the two with the smallest differences. Now you subtract this, or let's say since it's already minus 350, you add it to the total. So say you have 470 here, right? So 470 minus 350 minus 10 will give you a 110, right? So you choose the smallest differences and you then calculate the final cost. So basically, this is a four-step algorithm. If you try to understand this in terms of code, here's how you can code it. To fly everyone to one city, you need to sum up, you need to say assume that everybody is going to the first city. So in that case, we put all of the costs of getting each individual to the first city into one list. And then we sum it all. Now to evaluate the differences, we create another list called diff. And we add the and then we calculate the differences using a loop, right? And we add all of these. Oh, sorry, we don't add these. We sort these, right? Because we want to find the two minimums. Then you choose the smallest ones. So how do we know how many smallest to choose? Since in our input example, we have four individuals, we know that two have to be sent to each city. Say if you have six, you know that you need three in each city and so on. So basically, the length of the input divided by two will give you the number of people that should go to each city. So once you calculate that, you sum it up, right? So you sum up, say, in according to previous example, minus 350 and minus 10. And then you add it to the initial sum or the initial assumption that you made. So basically, if you combine all of this code, it'll look something like this. So I have just put the same code and cramped it up into three lines. So this is how you can actually solve the two city scheduling problem. I will link the solution to this down below as well, and I will also link the reference that I followed. I hope I made it easier for you to understand this problem. If you enjoyed watching this video and if you found it helpful, make sure to hit like, because it definitely means a lot, and consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching.